for the Phoenix Suns. They'll now go to 31-2 in their last 33 games and have their second 15-game winning streak of the season. It's been an amazing year.
Fellas, 15 in a row.
All right. Take that.
Way to go, guys.
Way to work it.
But, you know, the thing we got to keep in mind, and this is huge, none of us has won a title. We've got to go one more level. And that's going to take, you know, when you're tired, because in the playoffs, you're going to be tired. And you know what? You got to know when you got to put the hammer down. And I'm not going to let you slide, guys. I'm not going to let you slide. I hope I don't offend anybody or whatever. We got to go one more level. One more level. All right? It's a hell of a job any way you cut. Hey, you guys are great. Let's just know where we're going, all right?
Let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Come on.
Suns, 1, 2, 3.
Suns.
Let's go. Let's go.
Hell of a job.
Suns, 1, 2, 3.
Suns. Let's go. Let's go.
Hell of a job.
Mikey, 7:30, just meet in the lobby.
The Phoenix Suns have built a championship contender with some of the NBA's top stars. Yet their true strength lies not with their talent as individuals, but their unity as a team. The Suns have formed a bond that is extraordinarily tight.
There it is right there. Bruce City.
You know, this is my 13th year in the league. I've never been on a team where basically there's been a lot of nights where you've had just about all 14 guys out together. I mean, that's really, really unusual. And if you talk to guys on other teams lots of time, it's almost shocking news to them because so often you have a lot of teams, you'll have, you know, 2-3 guys max that go out. And, you know, but sometimes nobody goes out. So this is it's a pleasant change.
Screened by Barry Zhao, who's just checked in the game. Intercepted by Marion. Nash. Marion. Spectacular basketball by the Phoenix Suns.
You know, and it's just it's the way the team is built up. You know, and it's funny at times. If y'all get to see everybody in some of the great moments, it's hilarious around here.
After the game, the Patriots stand in the midfield doing the Merriman dance.
You fair game to make something like that every time you sack my quarterback. If I win, and I'm not supposed to win, oh, I'm gonna give you all of that.
We all have personalities to where it's contagious and it's addictive. These guys are great guys off the court. They're funny. The family's great. I mean, everything is pretty fun, and it's pretty much what I've been around my whole career. So I don't know anything else.
The Suns' off-the-court camaraderie has helped to fuel their on-the-court chemistry. They have an unselfish approach in which each player sacrifices for the greater good of the team. A philosophy that's been instilled by their head coach, Mike D'Antoni.
Hey guys, the big thing in this game, we're going to score pretty easy. We just can't get lulled in and not really playing hard down there. And I know it's hard sometimes, but we got to do that. Keep tightening our defense up. You'll have forwards.
I think Mike, he's really good at managing, you know, players and making them feel like he's on their side.
Oh, shoot! Ah, damn. Here we go, quick!
Coach D'Antoni's one of the great guys you'll ever deal with in this business. I've been in 30 years, and he's about as good a human being to talk to because he's has no ego, at least none that's apparent to anybody that's around him.
A long way from Phoenix is the place where Mike's personality and character began to take shape, the small rural town of Mullins, West Virginia.
I mean, it was a simple life in the sense of a great life. I wouldn't change it for the world. It wasn't a whole lot of decisions to be made. It wasn't a whole lot of, you know, worldly things going on. It was just really localized into a set of values that stay with you.
The son of a prominent coach, Mike was a star on his high school and college teams and went on to play 3 seasons in the NBA and ABA. But after being released in 1976, he found himself out of a job. His career to Italy, where he spent the next 21 years. D'Antoni led his teams to 5 titles as a player, 2 more as a coach, and came to appreciate the family atmosphere.
And that's what made the Italian experience great, was having 4 afternoons with all your teammates and all their wives and all their friends and all the writers. We all became happy and fun. That is the essence of what life's about to me, and the relationships and stuff. And again, if I have those relationships, what else do you need?
So you look at this guy and you say, wait a minute now, born in West Virginia and found himself in Italy, just that type of a journey has helped him tremendously, because now he's open always to new ways and new things to do. And that's why he's a very unique coach.
We've got a technical on Mike D'Antoni. And he's got his second one. He's out of here. Mike D'Antoni just got tossed from the game.
I'm not sure what he said, but he must have been working on his vocabulary, because he's out of here quick. Something must have literally set him off.
He's a great guy, but he conceals his competitiveness and his desire to excel.
When it comes time to compete, and I've competed against him in Italy, I mean, he is a dog. He will dog you. He'll do anything to win. And again, that's something that's very appealing to teams that he's coached, and it's very appealing to this team right now that's trying to get over the hump and have a chance to compete for an NBA championship.
You know, Mike's a great competitor. You know, you see him on the sidelines, and he's so laid back off the court, but he gets fired up on the sidelines. And, you know, I think, in many ways, I'm just like that.
Two-time MVP Steve Nash has become the extension of his coach on the court.
Nash is not a really yelling type of speaker, but he's like that little second voice in the ear.
Hey, concentrate!
Dion taking his time, finds Nash, puts up a three, and got it! We're going to overtime.
The team-oriented style of Nash and D'Antoni has set the tone for a state of harmony on the Suns. But even on the closest of teams, there are outside influences that can threaten to unravel the fabric of togetherness.
One of the difficult things for an NBA team is that everybody has this idea about the locker room camaraderie and everybody hanging out, but they all have agents, they all have friends, they all have family telling them things. Your agent's telling you you should be the MVP, and your coach is telling you you have to give up shots for the good of the team. And it is a constant battle, even if you have good guys. And I think Mike fought that with he fights it with everybody, even fights it with Steve Nash.
You know, not everyone's capable of sacrificing for the good of the group, and that's why the simplest of aspirations can be difficult. I think that each team fights that, and I think our team probably has to fight that some too.
You gonna kill us tonight?
Huh?
You gonna kill us tonight?
Yeah, I'm doing a little something like that.
I know. Don't go too rough, all right?
All right, got you.
Stoudemire digging inside and gets it a home with a massive crunch.
Amare Stoudemire is dominating once again, something few envisioned 18 months ago.
NBA news of the day, and unfortunately it's very bad news down in the Valley of the Sun. Amare Stoudemire underwent surgery on his left knee, and he will be out for the next 4 months.
It was like, oh my gosh, if he doesn't come back, what are we going to do? I mean, we're done.
The budding superstar had suffered a devastating injury, and he would have to undergo microfracture knee surgery, which few players had ever fully recovered from.
My friends and family always told me to just stay positive, and I was like, yeah, whatever, man, because it was so hard. It's harder than it looks. I had a few doubts. Would I be able to push through the frustration, even though I feel this pain or this discomfort?
I don't want to say too much during this session. Too painful.
As Amare struggled with the physical and psychological impact of his injury, the organization wondered if he would ever be the same.
They just didn't think that he was being fair to himself, but not working and trying to get back to the level that he needed to be at to be the best player that he could be.
While he continued his long road back, Amare could only watch the season unfold. And despite his absence, the Suns flourished, relying on a collective effort.
Together,
team-like performance that you would expect from this team.
It was definitely tough. You know, I wanted to play so bad. I wanted to help my team win, you know, as much as I could. But all I was able to do was cheer.
They even went a game further than they had the previous season, losing in six games in the Western Conference Finals.
The Dallas Mavericks eliminate the Phoenix Suns in six games, and they go to the NBA Finals.
You either come back from it, and you learn from it, and you appreciate what you have and makes you better, or you feel sorry for yourself, and you never get over the hump.
Basketball is all about challenges. Respect is not really just given to you. You gotta work for it. You gotta strive for it.
Returning to the Suns, Amari had regained his health and his faith in his abilities. But now, as he came off the bench, he would have to reintegrate himself into the team.
Trying to get Amari back into the mix and still win at the same time is going to be a difficult chore for Mike D'Antoni and the Suns.
He was really struggling with how he fit into the team, and I think vice versa. The team was pretty unsure about where he was at and didn't want to regress trying to work him back in.
We had roles last year on a team that played really well and went really far, and guys were used to those roles. And Amari coming back just put us kind of behind the eight ball as far as chemistry early in the season.
When the Suns started out 1-5, the answer became painfully clear to Amari. Instead of the team adjusting to him, they would have to adjust to each other.
I think he grew up a lot by watching and understanding that it's not about one person. It's about the team as a whole and what they can do.
But as Amari began to find his way, the Suns found their rhythm, and they would begin a remarkable run.
It was just amazing. Once he went into that starting lineup in early November, things just went fast forward.
It's game time, baby.
Stoudemire, my goodness, a Statue of Liberty dunk.
Nash pushes it up down the left side. The lob, the catch, the stuff by Stoudemire. Pretty play.
How good does it feel to have that explosion again at will, like seemingly whenever you want?
It feels great. You know, it's been a long time coming, you know, and it's definitely coming back slowly but surely. And I have more to grow. You know, I'm still not quite there yet. So I got about 4 more inches to gain on my vert.
How scary is that?
It's not scary for me. It's probably scary for the opponents.
Suns continue to click on all cylinders. And there he goes, with confidence and full flight, taking this Phoenix team with him to a 17th straight win.
It felt great. You know, it felt that I was back to my old dominant self, that I was able to play good team basketball.
Doesn't take long for that Phoenix machine to start cranking, and here they come.
He's really grown and improved and tried to understand what we're trying to do and given us a big presence, one that I don't think we can win the championship without. And I've been really proud of what a teammate he's been.
That's the reason why I changed my jersey to number 1. Because it all goes back to unification. That's what a team is all about.
I think that Hartown's reveals character, and it's revealed it in Amari's case.
Nash drives to his right, bounces the ball to Stoudemire, finds him for a jam, and he's fouled.
Yes. He showed everybody how dedicated and how much he wants to be the best player in the NBA. Make sure, like we talked about before, we're not going to beat ourselves. So if this team comes in like Washington and they did that, that's fine, but nobody's beating ourselves, all right? Here we go, guys.
Let's go. Go.
Suns, 1, 2, 3.
Suns, go, get shots up.
Now in his 8th season, Sean Marion is the longest tenured Sun and a crucial part of their success. The man known as the Matrix is a model of consistency and versatility, who has mastered every skill and can fill many roles.
Every NBA player has to exactly, you know, figure out, like, what he is. Sean, from the moment he came in to this point, is just a player, like a basketball player.
The Suns lead it. Marion with 12 points, 13 rebounds, another double-double for the Matrix.
Here's McGrady driving in. Ball is knocked away nicely by Marion in another great defensive play.
We understood that one of the reasons we could play and do the things that we do and the system that we have is because of Sean Marion. You know, there's very few guys in the league, guys, that you can ask to guard Tony Parker one night, and then the next night you're playing in Houston and you go, can you guard Yao tonight? And I think he understands that we really, really appreciate what he does for our team and that we don't take anything that he does for granted.
He was on fire tonight. You know, he came out the gates on fire. And I think he had a great game.
Despite being a four-time All-Star, Sean is often obscured in the shadows of his more celebrated teammates, Nash and Stoudemire.
Well, I think he definitely gets overlooked. It's got to be frustrating for the guy. I mean, he's a 2010 guy, doesn't get nearly the pub that other guys get. As a man, it's got to be tough.
There was a scene last year when there was one of those drum elementary school drum lines out there. And Amari hadn't played all season. And you looked out on the thing, and all the T-shirts said Stoudemire or Nash, the kids were wearing.
Who's your favorite player?
Steve Nash.
How about you? Who's your favorite?
Amari Stoudemire.
Everybody try to get in this, you know, do I get this, do I get that, man? You know, I'm not even right now focused on them, focused on my goals and my team goals. And, you know, it's going to come, but, you know, the people who really do know basketball know what I do, so I don't even really trip, man. It is what it is sometimes.
To me, there's nobody else in the league that can do
it. I mean, thank you.
Sean is a very sensitive guy, and, you know, he's been around here longer than any of those guys, and, you know, it's tough, I think, when you're the focal point of a team and then all of a sudden someone else walks in and they become the focal point of the team. There was Amari, you know, who was all of a sudden Rookie of the Year, and then there was Steve, who was MVP and all of that, and then all of a sudden, you know, Sean had taken a back seat. You know, he was the third guy, you know, on the team.
But Marion's feelings have not gone unnoticed by his coach, whose expertise goes far beyond the X's and O's.
He seems to have a real pulse on his players. He seems to know when someone is upset, he knows exactly when he needs to go over and say, is everything all right? Do we need to talk?
And then if you and Raja are having trouble in this cross matches, or yeah, Raja gets taken down.
He's good at coming at you and talking to you in a way that you understand he's trying to help you more than scold you or try to make you look bad. It's really out of a caring, you know, part of his heart.
You played perfect last night. Yeah, all in all, he's good. But you know what? None of his points hurt us. And he didn't get on the foul. He didn't get on the foul line. That's perfect.
As a coach, you try to stay in tune with everybody's feelings and how they are accepting their role and how's everything's going. Because it's not fair all the time. Sometimes Steve and Amari, they get credit, but it was really Sean who did it all.
5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Nash on the drive. Shot won't go. Rebound once, twice. Yes, Marion, the Matrix.
Well, everybody can be overlooked. Everybody can feel sorry for themselves. And you stay in tune with it. Try to help them to get over that. But he's not overlooked within the organization. He's not overlooked in the coaching staff. He's not overlooked by the city of Phoenix. So if ESPN or somebody puts Amari's name up or Steve, hey, that's them. That's not us. That's not who we are in this dressing room. And we got to deal with it.
That's a hell of a job. All of it. Sean, what you did, we're ready to pick it up. Just keep on going right now. Let's just keep this feeling. Let's keep this intensity. Let's keep this level.
One thing I learned a long time ago when I was young, coming up, it don't matter how good, you know what I'm saying, you are individually, but if your teammates ain't you ain't winning, and your teammates ain't gelling, y'all ain't gelling like that, it don't matter, because you ain't getting no accolades. When the team wins, you win. And the coaches win, everybody wins.
Don't put any doubts in anybody's mind that we can be beat. So let's come out, just focus and play our game, and we should be fine.
We should win it this year. If we don't win it, we'll be disappointed.
You said you should win it this year?
No, with the talent we have, if we continue to improve, there's no reason why we can't win it.
The ultimate test of the Suns' unity will come in the pressure of the playoffs. After two straight defeats in the conference finals, they know that their brilliant regular season is just the first step on the road to a title.
We're proud of our performance, but we're not gonna make a parade routes yet.
what's important to us is to continue to get better. So when the playoffs come, you know, we have the best chance to win a championship, and we don't look back and say, the games where we didn't improve through the season and we didn't prepare ourselves well enough to win in the playoffs.
Our defense keeps getting better, and that's just something that we got to keep getting better. We're not there. We can get a lot better. Our stances, our corrals.
For our first practice, we gathered around, and Mike, he just said, hey, if we don't win the championship, it's not going to be looked as a successful year. We're good enough to do it, and I expect to do it.
We got to come out focused, playing, getting better every game, keep it going. Winning keeps me up at night, but it's great having these guys and knowing that as you go into battle, then we have a heck of a shot of winning every night.
Let's go, baby. Let's go, Jets. Serve. 1, 2, 3. Serve. Yeah.
Right now, we got the ultimate. I mean, we want to try to win a championship. It's not going to be enough to go out in the conference finals.
Okay.
Winning a championship is something that I always dreamed of. I mean, I literally dream of it.
If the Suns are to achieve their championship dream, they'll have to do it the only way they know how, by relying on each other.
It's the Phoenix Suns. It's a group of individuals that together play better than any of them can play individually. And that's what we have right now. And that comes from our guys binding together and, you know, obviously led by Steve, but that's Sean buying in, that's Amari buying in. Their personalities blending as one.
There's no egos on this team, man. Everybody's going out there playing and having fun with each other. Everybody just coming in and just taking the D'Antoni approach.
Personal awards are great, but this is a team sport, and the only ones that really matter are the team awards.
Here's Nash, another three.
Oh, no!
And the only team award that really is given is the championship, so for me, that's the only thing there is.
So everybody's in a good state of mind, I think.
Yeah, we feel good. We feel good. Winning cures all problems. I look at team as the same as my jersey. It's number one. Look at a team as the same as a circle. That's what a team is all about. A team is about one. It's about one goal, one team, one family.